Well, snakes are out, and if you don't know which ones are poisonous, you could be in trouble if you ever come in contact with one. Wendi Hartup is here from Forsyth County Cooperative Extension to give us some tips and hopefully save us.
Yeah.
All right, so now how many snakes out there in North Carolina are venomous?
Well, there's only six across the whole state.
Only six.
Only
huh?
six. And then only three are ever found in the Piedmont. But really, people only see, you know, the copperheads. The cottonmouths are going to be found more in wet, really wetland type areas, so that's why we don't see them very much. The timber rattlers are found more in the mountains, so. Mm-hmm. It's really maybe you'll see a copperhead.
All right. It's, you know, it's kind of scary. You open your patio door and you walk
right.
outside and maybe one of those is just hanging out there. So what can we do to kind of
right.
keep them out of our yard?
Okay. Well, first of all, you really need to understand your enemy that you don't like, right? So they eat lots of stuff. They eat bugs and lizards and roaches and all kinds of things. Mm-hmm. So you need to detract them. So we want to control our insect population and our lizard population. So you could change your outside lights to a yellow color so it doesn't attract as many spiders and insects.
Uh-huh.
You can reduce their habitat by just trimming your shrubbery that's up close to the house 1 foot away from the foundation all the way up.
Uh-huh.
And because all of our critters are more comfortable traveling, you know, right up against a wall.
Hmm.
And so if you do that, then you're not creating that travel lane. So they'll be reduced
and
that
And the bugs
way.
And all that stuff, that's
and
their
the bugs,
food.
Right. And that's how they get in your house, is they travel all along in that safe zone and they find a crack or crevice to get in. So, and then, you know, other things could be move your compost bin further away from the house. Because, of course, if you've got a compost bin, you probably have all kinds of critters already there. So those would be your biggest things, I
All
think.
All right, need to get to work here.
Right.
All right, so now if you encounter a snake, what should you do?
I think you
run
should...
Run like crazy.
Well, back away slowly, and then you could run. But if you're really fast, right, you know, you might freak them out. You're just a giant tree to them, and they're going to be trying
to defend
themselves.
Of me, right?
They're way more scared of you.
No, I don't think
so.
So,
you know, if you're not comfortable killing it with some kind of implement, I would say stay far away.
Back away
right,
from the snake.
They can strike half... their body length. So you definitely want to just leave them alone. They'll move on.
Okay. 703-2850 to get some more advice from her.